full now.
See, Bryce, you know, Bryce, we get a guest in studio, and now you're
it. Can I tweet?
Yes, tweet please. It yeah. Yeah. Yeah, let's get the word out.
Yeah, so
we're live now at diamondclub.com.
We're live on diamondclub.tv. The show is at Night Attack Show on Twitter, if you'd like to mention it.
Yeah.
Hold on a second.
Yeah.
Diamondclub.tv.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Man, if we had it all to do over again, like on purpose, there's a lot of different off ramps we would have taken.
Okay, so just this, I'm going to tweet that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. No, it's not done. Happy Tuesday, everybody.
Here we go. Oh, freestyling, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Have you noticed that the getting worse on the...
Hey, did you upgrade to 10?
Mine isn't getting worse,
I'm going to wait until everyone's got all their problems.
Yeah.
I was like...
We didn't tell you about last night, did we?
Oh, me?
At Night Attack?
At Night Attack Show. What happened last night?
Oh, we took a pit stop.
Where?
All the way back. Stopped at Boomers. That grimace.
Sorry, I didn't even know my nose could sneer. I didn't know that noses sneer.
Y'all can't see Bonnie, but her face started shaking like the girl in Stranger Things. And a single trail of blood came out of her nose.
I love that show. As soon as
the mention of Boomers became...
So the whole reason that Boomers is on our...
Tweeting.
Yeah, you got it. You got it. Done.
Oh, we're live?
But that's all right.
Yeah, we are live, but we're not...
But this is pre-show, which means it's not the real
episode
show.
Episode proper.
Yeah, but that's not going to work for me.
No? You just got to go full show? Oh yeah, you want to get to it? You want to step two? We can step two.
You know, it's like,
so here's what we usually do.
I watch your show.
Okay, right on.
I watch, you know, in preparation. Mm-hmm. I spend some time of like, man, this show at Comic Con blows. That was
The Dragon Con?
Dragon Con.
Yeah, you were not a fan.
No, it was weird.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's weird. A weird show.
It is a weird show. Blows is another synonym for weird. Yeah.
Blows like the breeze.
Who can tell where it's blowing?
But then I went back and I understood the setup and the different room and the different day.
Yeah.
Like, okay. So now I felt it.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, that Dragon Con show is really so much more about the live audience. Like, it's all just about like everybody.
It's very difficult to make a televised product in a live setting.
Exactly.
Like that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's difficult for you to make a televised product in your studio. I mean, we have two cameras. We never switch.
We do switch.
Oh no! You'll see. It'll be halfway to dynamic. Something like that.
Yeah.
So we usually begin, the fans always put together a pre-show document for us where they collect a bunch of horse shit for us to get warmed up. Jesus Christ.
What is that?
That's pretty good.
That's our Photoshop class. Yeah.
This is shop class. Yeah.
Yes.
Shop
class. Here, let me see. Can I take charge?
Sure. Do you want to scroll down for the other Photoshop?
Am I allowed to see this?
Because it absolutely.
Looks
like... Absolutely.
Yeah. 7-Eleven was a part-time job. Classic. There it is.
Look at this.
Nice. You got it.
A diamond clip.
All right. So they put together where's the video?
So the audience tells you what you're going to do?
There you go.
Our pre-show, we'll just they'll find videos and we'll go through them.
Oh, man.
This is normally Brian and I'm like... fucking around and getting
under. Should bring the mic.
Come on, open up.
I think we should be all right.
I just see someone saying it.
I lock myself in here for your safety. But I'm going to be okay.
This is just copyright infringement.
It's a new segment. By the way, that was probably the best thing we ever did at Twit, was a segment we called Copyright Infringement, where all we did was play Star Wars with Lady Gaga over it.
And by the way, never got pulled down.
That's amazing.
Yeah, yay. For real. Like everything, we'd get fucking flagged and pulled down for a million other different things. But when you play Lady Gaga's applause over the Emperor hitting Luke Skywalker in Return of the Jedi...
He did it. That magnificent bastard.
What is
it? Oh, he did a diamond.
So this is the Holovac.
This is our friend Jaime Ruiz, who put together this. He's trying to make essentially the R2-D2, you know, holographic projection thing. And fuck me, he made a Diamond Club logo in 3D.
That's amazing.
That's extraordinary.
Told him he should have waited. Does he have a Flex radio in the back?
I think that's a Plex.
It's Plex. It's his Plex server, I'm sure. Okay,
thank you. So I'm sure he's... let's see. What else we got?
Dick will make you slap somebody?
You want Dick or you want Man Beast?
Let's go Dick will make you slap somebody.
That one's yesterday.
Dick will make you slap somebody?
Oh, you did?
So the original concept of the show was you show...
But it's not the problem, though. She said the dick was so good.
That was the original.
She started rocking. She just got into it, and all of a sudden, she said, something just hit her. Bam! All upside his head. Just slapped him. Dick will make you slap somebody. So y'all need to remember that. That's what I'm trying to do.
That's a classic.
It's fact.
This is a classic clip.
Fantastic. Oh, really? Dick will make you slap somebody?
Oh, yeah.
Classic?
Oh, yeah.
Let me see your knees, please, Brian. Oh, Jesus. Hold on. sorry, too late, Bonnie. We're on the internet.
Some people call it a problem. Some people call it a disease. But the one thing the fuck is sure, I just love staring at knees. They've got those itty bitty 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 bumps. Getting that tibia and other bony bones. Don't
knees.
Want that fleshy bounce and secondary room. Just want that sensitive.
That's our fetish.
You know one time I'm on my head racing in my breath.
I mean, there's only 91 people.
Was crushed. I'm basing her new shoes.
What's the issue?
And I couldn't help but fathom this
down. We were asking if there was a fetish community for knees. We couldn't find one, so we made one on Reddit.
Wait,
apparently
called D's Knees.
D's.
Look at this. This is apparently.
You know what?
Well, this is archival footage, Bonnie. Yeah. This is not an unedited reel.
I'm sure that this wasn't what they actually made. This wasn't like sponsored by Texaco and Winston.
This is porn.
Yeah.
I can have my fantasies. I mean, they were kind of, you know, those guys were kind of.
Are you
into
women?
It wasn't like Perry Cuomo introducing, and now the knee fetish.
Holy shit. Gazorpazorp Field minus Gazorpazorp Fields. Are you kidding me?
Field.
Oh, so good.
Aw.
Have you?
Come on, Gazorpazorp Field. Go easy on me, huh?
So, oh, jeez. This is like 12 layers deep in the Matrix. Are you familiar with Rick and Morty? You watch that?
I've watched it, yeah.
Oh, okay. So this is the episode where they're watching shows from other worlds.
Jeez, Gazorpazorp Field. That's, you know, you're pretty mean to me, but that takes the cake.
Somebody mashed that up with the whole Garfield minus Garfield meme.
Got it.
And
hey, Rick, you know, did they use Bill Murray for this? Sounds a lot like Bill Murray.
I never understood the minus Garfield thing until I saw this one. So now I get it.
Oh, really? Yeah, no, yeah, the John's like a basket case.
Really, yeah, now it seems really kind of sad and weird.
Wait, have you ever seen the Gazorpazorp Field, the original clip?
No. Oh, Jesus.
All right,
so
let's actually get that going.
Gazorpazorp Field.
So the idea is in this episode that they've plugged in an interdimensional cable box. So they're watching shows from other dimensions. Yeah, and they're just like flipping through the channels.
Seems plausible.
And this is the Gazorpazorp Field.
So good.
Oh, I hate my mom and dad's days. And I really could go for some enchiladas. Hey, Rick, that's pretty cool. It's just like Garfield, only instead it's a Gazorpazorp Field. Hey, isn't Gazorpazorp where those sex robots came from? Remember that whole thing? Yeah. Hey, that's a pretty... That's true. That's right. Yeah. Let's watch some more Gazorpazorp Field. Hey, John. It's me, Gazorpazorp Field. Boy, fuck you, John. You fucking dumb, stupid idiot.
Come on, Gazorpazorp Field. Go easy on me, huh?
You dumb, stupid... Weak, pathetic, white guilt, milk toast, piece of human garbage.
Jeez, Gazorpazorp Field, that's, you know, you're pretty mean to me, but that takes the cake.
I don't give a fuck. I'm Gazorpazorp fucking Field, bitch.
Yeah, I am.
Now give me my fucking enchiladas. Hey, Rick, you know,
I don't know. I think that could be strangely cathartic if you were to, like, you know, sign up that for a weekly session of.
Gazorpazorp Field.
You're so pathetic.
It's the code in which I live my life.
Robot straps a tattoo, a human down, and tattoos them. What? What?
Oh God.
What?
What is this?
What?
Fuck that noise. No way. No way.
Oh my God.
Jesus.
Oh my God. What is happening?
That was awful.
pretty good, actually.
Do not try this at home. Yeah, don't build a giant fucking one-armed tattooing robot at home, please. With GoPros
with
all
the GoPro!
Nice.
Oh, that's horrible.
Yeah, like I guess it was blood. More ink streaming out than blood.
Well,
yeah,
it's a little light.
Wow. Boy, look like prison
you know, my
tattoos.
Daughter does stick and poke on all her
oh,
friends.
Oh, yeah, we've got a
That's
fan.
Crazy,
we got a fan who did a jailhouse tat of the Diamond Club to himself while watching the show. Yeah. It was fucking amazing.
Like, my daughter's really good at it.
Really?
Oh,
yeah,
does
I'm
all
sure.
Her, yeah, does
yeah
all
is
her
that
friends.
Like how long does it take to like get good at it? Like, how long has she been doing
she's
it?
Always, she's very artistic.
Dude, there
gotcha.
It is.
So just got into, you know.
He did this during the show. So he tweeted us by the end of the show of this homemade tattoo that he made.
Dude, that's my daughter actually has NSFW on her.
No,
yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you tell her that we're now Night Attack now?
Yeah, she should probably change it. That's no. That's not our show name anymore.
Wait, your daughter does not.
Not for
Is
our
she
show.
A fan?
No.
No. No.
That's very wishful thinking, Bonnie. It's very wishful.
I do know. No.
So self-absorbed, I know.
You would have met her if you hadn't bailed on me.
Which time?
At the bandana ball.
Oh, yes. How was that? I was out of town, right?
What was the bandana ball?
That was your cookout, right?
No.
No?
The Ronald McDonald House. It's a big, big event. I asked you to come because I figured you'd have some money to give.
Mm.
Like, you're wrong.
Good also wishful thinking.
Good dodge.
You see our studio now,
nice.
Right? I
mean. Nice.
shit. All right. Well, I owe you.
You
one.
Avoided
all
a soak
I
in there.
I look no, that's forward good. To.
The only
that's
way you get donations is from the cursing bet.
The oh yeah.
The belt bet.
The belt bet. Yeah.
So.
Let's see, what else we got on the video list?
Yeah, let me see what else we got. How could driverless cars cause chaos?
My daughter would probably actually dig this show.
Right on.
Why driverless cars will cause
Oh my God! This
chaos.
Is our boy!
Oh my God.
What?
In the next few years,
yes!
Driverless cars will become commonplace on our roads. As I speak, the technology is having its final tweaks before it becomes live. The promise is that cars, by working together through their computer systems, will help traffic flows. These self-drive cars will also result in fewer traffic jams. This is due to less sudden braking than human drivers, which often results in traffic jams and traffic disruptions.
Jesus
Christ. Find a traditional parking space
where
available to conserve fuel and wear and tear.
This is what happens when you try to branch out.
He doesn't sound stupid enough.
Location.
Should stick to ruining magic tricks.
Oh, like,
so in the early days of driverless cars.
The reason why we're obsessed with this guy is he's from New Zealand, and primarily what he does is reveal his assumptions on how magic tricks are done.
Whether he's right or wrong.
But he does them in these crude and ridiculous illustrations.
Well, driverless cars is indeed pretty much a magic trick at this
point. Sure, right?
Yeah.
But he has his catchphrase. Which is, but how could this have been done?
Okay.
That's really good.
But so now he's like he's expanding.
Ass? Oh. What is this?
What?
Like, that is definitely that is a donkey's asshole.
Oh my God!
What the fuck?
It looks like a cat, like when he has the tail up. You know,
during
like
a TV show, performer Keith Barry noticed a passerby carrying a newspaper. He said to the passerby that he would write down a word.
Yeah, who cares?
Come on, get to the catchphrase.
Oh, okay. Wait for it. Looking
oh,
for
wait,
him.
No, I think you passed it.
Oh, did I?
It's him at the desk.
Oh, is it? Oh, shit.
I think
that's
right,
here we go. Let's see if he
does
his catchphrase.
The notepad and the same word was written on the pad.
But
Keith and an off-camera psychological expert explained that people can see peripheries of pencil lead hidden
what?
In his thumbnail.
Oh, shit. That did
or
not
some
look like a pencil lead
device.
On a thumb. It looked like something else.
Or maybe a person when subliminally shown.
Right. I love the like PowerPoint clip art.
Yeah, the Microsoft Paint.
Paint, right, it's even better.
Oh. All right, what are we doing here?
So this is setting up for what you're going to do on the real show?
No, this is us just getting it out of our system.
Just getting,
every
getting
so
loose.
Often we find something that that tickles us just right.
And when does the real show start?
We usually start it in 20 minutes. We can start earlier.
Oh,
really,
no,
though.
We can start in 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers, a fucking game.
That X going to give it to you?
what you hearing. Oh my God. Guy walking through the thrift store like a boss. Oh yeah, he's gonna give it to you.
Marcus Couch. This is good as the show gets. No, Marcus, it's apparently pre-show.
No, it gets much worse. Oh my God, this is an actual full-on parody corporate video?
I mean, it's just a corporate video to X Go Give It To You.
No! The enemy is Los Angeles.
All right.
Let's see. That's so wimpy. Is there anything you're feeling, Justin? I say we get started.
That's so wimpy. Come on.
I got a pre-show thing.
Oh, you had a pre-show? Yeah. Unless you want to, do you want to tell the boomer story during the pre-show?
Yeah. All right. Let's get warmed up. All right, so we went. So I went and picked up. What?
I had a pre-show story.
Oh, I'm sorry. Bonnie, go ahead.
Totally, like just fucking swooped in and took it away from us. Like,
run over.
I really, bro.
To you, motherfuckers. That's how it's gonna go.
Bonnie gonna give it to you.
Not gonna give it to me.
What's the haps? So set up. I'm driving Penny to school, and there's nothing I can do. I'm in Austin traffic. It's. You know, I'm driving. It's on the way back.
What road are you on?
I am on Mopac.
Oh. Going way local. Way local, you guys.
Fuck, it is Mopac. It's crazy. Blows, yeah. And actually, it's on the way home because Penny's not in the car. I wouldn't have panicked. But all of a sudden, I hear from the back, Callie says, Mom. Callie's a three-year-old, by the way. Callie goes, Mom, I'm sucking my toe. And I said, No! You know, complete panic.
Like, why? Why would she be panicked?
Because she hadn't washed that toe. She was filthy. Yeah, she was filthy.
That's going to make a woman out of her.
She'll develop breasts now.
I guess.
No, it's like, you know, it's good to get bacteria. You know, get used to it. You eat dirt.
Yeah, she'll be a more robust germ profile.
I ate dirt.
Is this how you thought this was going to go? Keep going, buddy. No, it's going great. There's three of us now.
We're supposed to shut up. It's supposed to be quiet. This is Bonnie's pre-show story.
This is Bonnie's corner. Bonnie's corner.
Bonnie, go for it.
We're very respectful of Bonnie's corner.
And I say no with a horrified mom's voice. And she says, but it's got my gum on it.
Okay, that's good. I like that.
You saved it. You saved it.
The body brush for ladies.
Way to go.
Thank you.
Man.
True story.
So
she's developing those punchline skills early. By the way, so I've been friends with you guys for, what, 8 years now? Seven years?
Yep.
I feel like I've had the same conversation with a three-year-old the entire time.
Oh, because we keep replacing three.
Because you keep having, there's, at any time I'm here, there's a three-year-old who's having the same conversation with me. Okay. And today I was talking to Callie and I'm like, she's like, well, what? Like, when did you grow your beard? And I'm like, you know this. No, you don't. You're not either of your sisters that I've been talking to for the past 8 years.
So
they're complaining that my mic is low?
We can fix
that. We can goose it.
It's like I'm here on video for my face.
Yeah,
I don't want to be
close micing it, everybody. Here.
We were talking about your beard. I was saying on the way back. I was like,
B-wood. It sounds like the
B-word.
Yeah.
Beard.
You've got a big B-word.
Beard?
She might be saying that. But then I said, well, Justin's coming. And he goes, oh, he's got the beard. And then I said, yeah. And then she says, she goes, I'll eat ice cream and then I'll have a beard like Justin.
So, we're already out of beer. Speaking of
beer.
I'm going to go get some beer.
No. We got to tell the boomer story. We got to tell the boomer story because we only got X amount of time.
Okay, so real quick.
Bonnie's going to help out.
So there's a bar that I went to once to do magic, and there ended up being a fist fight there at the bar. So I'm sitting there.
Where was this?
It's up. You passed it on the way over. It's called Boomer's. At 290.
It's right off when it stops being a highway.
Biker bar?
I don't know what it is. Mm. You would think it's like a sports bar. Looks kind of like a sports bar.
It's like a Hooters. Contracted gig?
No. This was me helping
was
out.
Magic night, a magic right?
Yeah. A friend of was putting together a magic night.
Right.
And in an attempt to break up the fight, I tried to do like what they call a pattern interruption. And apparently, I had forgotten this story, but we were reminded of it last night. Apparently, I said, guys, guys! And then everyone looks, and I was like, did you guys know that Hitler developed meth? and then at some point I started showing pornography. Then we looked at China's clip.
You showed them now deceased pro wrestler China's clitoris.
Yeah, very large clitoris.
And did it work?
I apparently have very little memory of it. But we decide. So we're driving by. I pick up Justin at like midnight. So it's midnight. We're driving by, and it's like, hey man, you want to go? We should go in this bar. And I was like, you want to go to this dive bar? He's like, yeah. And so we go in, and I remember thinking like, oh man, I only know about this place because of this friend of mine, John Maverick. Look to my left, and there is the freshly divorced John Maverick. His pupils bigger than his eyes himself. That's how dilated they are. He's apparently been at it. He's holding a full pitcher of Ziegenbach that he's drinking from. We found out a lot of
he's newly divorced.
So newly divorced. You can imagine an uninhibited that one.
After I left my second wife, a friend of mine took me out for drink.
Yep.
Yeah.
And I almost bought a yellow Lambo.
What the
off
fuck?
Of eBay.
What the fuck?
You're like, yeah, man, but I have to get a midget to go in it to drive it for me because I can't drive. I need a midget to drive. Did you see there was a little person on Dancing with the Stars?
No, which one?
This is Howard Stern's show 20 years ago.
Hey,
now on
Rick
ABC.
Perry was a former governor. There's no need to start calling names.
It's fantastic. It was the funniest shit I've ever seen. You gotta love it. But that was Howard Stern had this. You got Rick Perry. You got Vanilla Ice.
Ryan Lochte.
Wait, Vanilla Ice. He does his first dance. There's a fucking car on stage. There's dancers behind him.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
What? Yeah.
Vanilla Ice, throughout all of my youth, was just the guy that you would see at the Broward Mall food court.
Wait, did they actually?
Super nice guy.
He lived in the same neighborhood that I grew up in.
You were in Florida?
In Florida. Mm-hmm. And he would just, everybody had a story of seeing Vanilla Ice in the Broward Mall food court. He was always very nice to everybody. He never had a dick story about him.
No. No one has a bad story. No, he's super nice. Yeah.
Man, that was an amazing thing to watch at the time, to have somebody like that's and I guess being in the radio business, you've seen this over and over again, where somebody's I don't want to say collapses under their own popularity, but the popularity becomes the very thing that they're riding to success and to monetary gain becomes the thing that everybody resents them for. Like I remember seeing Fatboy Slim, and everybody loved the entire show until they did Praise You, which I guess had been played one too many times on radio, and then people started throwing ice at Fatboy Slim.
Really?
Like, they're just throwing their drinks and shit. I'm like, he did nothing but made a very popular song. Why are you... Yeah. You paid money to come to this show. Why are you angry?
And there's probably more people there that bought a ticket because they liked the song Praise You than there are people there throwing ice at him for playing the popular song.
Yeah, no, that's that whole like, you're liking it for the wrong reasons crowd, which is very strange to me.
So anyway, Brian's friend is talking about how many people he's had sex with since he got divorced.
Careful.
Are we not telling this story?
Well, I don't know which part of the story. Oh, jeez. All right.
We've given names
now. Wait.
You gave the name.
All right.
We were in the trust tree.
Is
this on the way back? Just the other.
This was on the last way night. Back. He's telling some stories out of school. All right. So anyway. Another time, we left Boomers and we went to another bar.
Yes,
called
totally different
Zoomers.
Bar. and we ran into a totally another different friend. Guy. Totally different guy. This guy also had gotten recently divorced, and he was maybe a little bit upset about it. And maybe we got to talking about, you know, immediately, like within seconds, we're getting the rundown of which stuff he kept in the divorce or whatever, and about how, like, the mattress was going to be taken, and, you know.
Well, he had to give it up.
Yeah,
he had to give up the mattress.
But then he took a picture of, like, this is the mattress right before I gave it up. And it's got a woman. And it goes, and that ain't her.
So insinuating that he had slept with a woman. So then at some point later on in the conversation, the mattress comes back up. Mm-hmm. Right, about how he had to give her the mattress.
and then Justin's like, well, at least you gave it to her soiled, well, you know, with your ejaculate, basically. And he goes, oh no, I came on her tits. And then Justin's like, well, still the point stands. I would imagine some got somewhere.
I mean, some of it, right? Like, at some point, I mean, like, you know, like, if we're going to go with a black light, like, you know, you're going to see something flash.
And he goes, no, she licked it all up. And Justin goes, okay. And he's like, all of it. Like, just weirdly obsessed.
This was a real point. He wanted to drive this home. That there was not a dropped
spilled. Well, apparently he didn't drive it home, but... Just kind of
so
dropped
just
it
shot it. Yeah.
Shot it home.
I am. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Just recently married. Yeah.
No wonder.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, why is that?
And you guys are all hyped up about some jack-off story.
Oh, no. Yeah. Oh, no.
That's don't worry. That we're always unnaturally obsessed with jacking off and boners and okay. No.
Dicks at night.
Oh, right, Bonnie, body. Yeah. You kill me. Tacos at night.
All right. All
right. Did your wife just say that?
Yeah. Oh, no.
Tacos is, at night.
Yeah. She. I think I have an
Lay's donuts for breakfast.
Yeah. Hold on, woo! Bonnie definitely.
You did not. Oh wait. Now I know what you did.
Yeah. No, Bonnie. We're at fucking Taco Bell.
You know, it's like as the kids get older, 12, 8, and 3, there's only a few things you can say in front of them that is still innocuous.
Bonnie texts in all caps, I want tacos at night.
I did
and
not
so
I, say that.
That's what it's literally right here. Okay, well,
I want tacos at night.
All I caps. Wanted him to pick up Taco Bell.
Okay, you should have said, you should have said, I want Taco Bell then. Because instead.
So you guys had your own little emoji?
Oh, bitmoji. Yeah, no.
So
yeah.
I respond with the send pics bitmoji.
I mean, I'm still doing ASCII smileys. Yeah.
We got custom caricatures of ourselves.
Wait. You forgot the most important part. It says get up here.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Get up here.
Oh, my God. No. That was.
Shit. This is a thing.
That was how I could listen to tracks at night.
No.
All right, I'm feeling it. Are you guys feeling it?
I'm ready to go, yeah.
What I love about. Thank you for putting me on the Wi-Fi. So the first thing I did is like, should I turn the volume up on den, garage, master bedroom, or patio?
Oh, fuck yeah. You got on the Sonos.
I was trying to get on the Hue, but you have to press the bridge.
That's good. Very well done. Well played.
Wait, I'll just
have we started the show
there?
Yet?
Oh, wait. Are you, wait. Oh, there it is.
I didn't do it. It wasn't me.
Okay.
He's getting to the ears. All I got to say
like
is.
That.
Well played, Adam Curry. Yeah, that was a good one. Yeah.
I will definitely murder you if you turn on one of those.
One of which? Oh, the music? Wake up the daughter.
You know I wouldn't do that.
You get the bull.
I don't know. I don't know.
What do you take me for? What do you take me for?
You just hacked my house.
That's a new Nat Geo show. Hack my house.
I know. He rolls over for everybody.
And I could actually do it from outside of your house.
Yeah.
I know.
That was one of the weirdest moments is our editor, Brant, I guess he said,
once you're set up, you can do it anywhere.
Well, exactly. Right. Well, and he had been over
a few times.
I guess there was some file he didn't have, and I guess he texted me at like 1 in the morning because he's totally nocturnal and saying, "Hey, I don't have a file. I'm gonna come over, and if you're up, then I'll just grab it. Otherwise, I'll just get it
people
on Wi-Fi."
People are still complaining that I'm just not loud enough.
Yeah,
people are saying you need to talk more. That you haven't talked enough. Maybe but we're
maybe
like
we
running
need to
over
shut
you.
Up.
We need
but
to
the
shut
point
up
is
more.
Is like there's nothing weirder than at 2 a.m. you wake up and you go downstairs and there's a dude in a beanie hat with a glowing light of his laptop sitting on your front porch downloading files
from your
that
from
he
your
left. Yes, exactly. It's like, oh Jesus.
That's pretty funny.
Here's the thing is I'm pretty sure he does that all the time and we just
no, he
it.
Said he gave warning on
he
that
did.
One.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
I mean, people say, "Man, learn how to podcast," because I'm too soft. But that's clearly your dysfunctional setup here.
That's Scott. That's Scotty Mo. Scotty Mo's dad wrote me the other day.
Oh, really?
Daddy Mo?
Yeah,
Scotty Mo. What do you mean? Bryce's bandmate,
right?
And the Dandy Scots.
The Dandy Scots.
Oh, is that your band?
It's our defunct,
true dad beef.
Not a semi-defunct rock band.
Yeah. Right on. Oh yeah, right on.
Dvorak says Adam's volume is as low as this show's ratings.
Yeah. Holy shit, like man! That. You trying to scrab JCD? Come on.
You know he's not watching at all, at all, at all, at. All.
This is actually just a bot. He just puts chat bots into various things so we can talk shit on him.
I wish.
At all times.
I wish.
Are you guys feeling it?
Let's go.
Let's go. All right, here we go.
All right.
Feeling it.
I'm ready. I'm good.
You're ready to clear your throats.
So none of that's going to be on the show, all that genius material.
No. That'll
it
all
will
live
be preserved
on YouTube.
For,
yeah.
All right. We're going to do this all show. Right. We're going to watch this video, and then we're going to come into the theme music. So let's do that in 3, 2.